I'm Susan Treidman. I'm one of the co-authors of the Text Encoding and TEI module. And this is just a short video that you should watch before doing the Yates XML exercise. We're recommending you use the editor Oxygen. It is an XML-aware or parsing editor. You can get a free download for a month, but it is worth buying if you are going to continue to work with XML. And what this editor does, it checks that your file is both well-formed and valid. It's very handy because it provides you with an available list of elements and attributes at any point in the document. And if you follow this, it will keep you or help keep you from making mistakes. Just to go over a little bit of what you'll see when you open Oxygen, here on the slide, you'll see the first three, top three lines are what's called the processing instructions. The first line indicates that this is an XML document, version 1.0, that there is a style sheet attached. In this case, it's a CSS style sheet called Yates, and it's in a folder called style sheets. There's also a schema. In our case, it's a RelaxNG schema, and it's the TI Lite. And it's in a folder called schemas. This file path, the two dots before schemas and style sheets, indicate that in relation to this text, this document, the XML, the Yates document, it's up one folder. Go up one folder, and you'll see another folder called schemas. And in that, the X-Oxygen will find a file called TEI Lite RNG. This is really important. You need to keep your XML file in the folder structure that we provide, and I'll show you that in a minute or two. But here you could see when you open angle bracket, Oxygen will suggest what TEI tags are available in that point in the document. And here you can see title is available. That will allow you to not make a mistake and put the wrong tag. So if you don't see a tag there, an element there, don't choose it. Here is the same thing for attributes. So here I've opened responsibility, and the way you see the attribute value is you put your cursor at the end of the open element between the end of the word and the open angle bracket. You make a space and you see you get a list of available attribute values. And at the bottom of the page here, you'll see a list of error messages. Ideally, you don't have any, but sometimes we do have them. In this case, you could see that red underline shows that there's a missing value. In fact, it's an incorrect value, a bad value, as it says, for when. You can't have YYY month date. It has to be an integer, which we are going to give you later to fill in. So in our instructions, which you'll find in the extras folder, we'll be letting you know when there's an error message you can ignore from now. And if we don't say that and you get an error message, you should try to fix it. So I mentioned a little earlier that there's a document structure that we're giving you when you unzip the Yates exercise. You'll find four folders. Documents is where you'll find the Yates template. When you rename that, make sure you keep it in the documents folder. Make sure it doesn't go onto your hard drive, your desktop, a remote drive. If you don't keep it there, then that file structure in the processing instructions will break and you won't be able to parse your document. In extras, there's a few things. There's the text of the Yates poem you're going to do. There's also the instructions for this exercise and a challenge exercise. And as I mentioned before, there's two other folders. The schema, you'll find the schema we're using, the style sheet, the CSS. I can't stress this enough, but maintaining the paths is really important. And the paths come from the XML, in our case, TI document. In relation to that document, it looks for the style sheet and the schema. When you open it in the browser, if those paths are broken, you'll get an error message and won't be able to view what you're encoding. As I said, the paths are always controlled from the XML document itself. And again, here is the syntax that we use, and you'll see that that relates to the structure I just showed you of those four folders. So as I said, I can't stress it enough. People always mess up on this, but it's one error that's really easy not to make. Good luck with the exercise.